Greetings and salutations, and welcome back to Lodestar Gaming. My name is Tim, and it is Genshin Week. Yes, this game is one of my favorite games, and so I have to share it with the world. And this week, starting today, we are going to be running Genshin for 7 straight days at 3 o'clock Eastern Time in the afternoon. How is everybody doing? We are a little further ahead since you've last seen us. As you guys can see, I've got several characters that are up to level 90, and I have been working on Kokomi and Raiden and Nahida and on Kazuha. As you guys can see, I've got everybody up to 90, and I pretty much got everything maxed out except their artifacts, which I'm working on right now. Let me tell you what has happened since then. If you guys want to see something really cool, if you guys had missed 3.4, the second half of 3.4, one of my favorite characters dropped, Hu Tao. And I love Hu Tao. She is the best DPS in the game, in Genshin, by far. And she is very difficult to use, however. And she has to pretty much work with our friend Zhongli. Or have somebody who has got some ridiculous healing. But Hu Tao, I ended up dropping her. Now, I want to share this first episode with you guys because, as many of you know, 3.5 has come out. And 3.5 means Dia. And a lot of people don't know what's going on with Dia. And I was going to let you guys do a run, or show you guys a run of her. She's a very good character. I think she's A tier at this point. She's not necessarily a game tested person yet, and she has some mechanics that aren't quite there yet. There aren't a lot of teammates that she can use. The big news to me specifically is 3.6 is coming out, and 3.6 means Baiju. And I have not shown you guys Baiju, but we're going to go visit Baiju. I think he is around our friends in Liyue, so we're going to go ahead and visit him. But first, let's check out Dia. This is pretty cool if you guys have been playing the game. She is one of the first characters you meet in the expansion in Sumeru. So she is a pyro claymore. So, and as you guys can see, she's got an area of effect damage work. And of course, she runs very well with Bennett. And they run with Kaya as well, give it some of that elemental burst damage, and of course water with Barbara. But Dia is pretty cool. I do like this mechanic. It looks a little bit like, if you guys know Sino, she's got these claws that come out, which is absolutely cool. And she is, like I said, she is A tier, but she, if somebody wants to use her, she is quite a bit of fun. And the next banner, I believe, I'm not entirely sure who the main off banner is, but I do know that Mika is coming out. And if you guys know Mika, Mika has, I think he is one of the first characters to use 3 different weapons. I'm not entirely sure if he can equip 3 different weapons. I think he just uses them in his burst damage and his E. So, but as you guys can see, quite cool. Dia is quite cool. I do love this mechanic. I love the lion mechanic. It's very cool with her claws and everything like that. So I think that is really awesome. But somebody you guys might want to deal with, somebody you guys might want to use. I believe she is main DPS, so definitely use her if you guys want to. I'm more of a stats guy. I'm more of a guy that looks for damage and the best that I can get. Dia is definitely an A for you, an A class, but she is very good. And I think once they get more teammates with her, more people that can work with her, it's going to be a little bit better. Somebody I have not shown you guys yet, and I wanted to show you, was Sino. Sino is been re-released again. He was released, I believe, in 3.2, if I'm not mistaken, and he is a very popular character with everybody, and he is a main DPS as well. And he does something with Dendro, which is very cool. This is why Kale is in this group. And somebody that works very well with the problem is, and I think when my daughter was having this issue, was Sino is DPS, and of course Hytham is DPS, so you really can't have them both on the same team. It just does not work. But as you can see, Sino is excellent, and he is a very good DPS guy. I'm not. I think he's S tier or SS tier. But as you can see, what he does is he fires off Quicken with Kale's work. So he definitely, and the one he does definitely work best with, and you know, all these characters seem to work best with, is Nahida. Nahida is absolutely fantastic with him, and I don't think if I and I've seen a lot of. Genshin Lab and all those other ones, they're showing that he does not do anything except with Nahida. I mean, and Kale, he can in certain instances, but he really works with Nahida because Nahida enhances his Electro, so it's very important. So that is Sino. Sino's very cool. I know I haven't shared him with you guys. So, and of course, the last one, you guys know Bennett, and we've already messed with Bennett, so we're not going to do that. So, as you guys can see, I have Hu Tao, and I have built a team that has been recommended by my oldest daughter, and that is Raiden with Zhongli and Hu Tao. A very cool grouping and that I have found has been very effective. Now, obviously, Hu Tao's at level 60, and I have to level her up. If you guys see what I'm doing on this particular version today, on this particular episode of Genshin Week this week, we are going to start working, getting Hu Tao leveled up to 70. What my goal eventually is I want to have four parties at each at level 90 at each one. As you guys can see, I have my Geo party, which is number one team. Number two team is probably my favorite team right now. Number three team, I'm going to level up. You guys notice Kamisato Ayaka. They had in 3.4, they had a release of her new uniform, which I ended up buying. I loved it. It's a great uniform. And it was a great storyline, too, and a quest line. I should have shared it with you guys. I didn't. Sorry, been busy, but we'll get her going. Then Kazuha, of course, Mona and Diona. So I have to get Mona, Diona, Hu Tao, and I sometimes have Xing Qiu, but right now Raiden has been okay. And I think I need to move Albedo out of here. I need to put Xing Qiu in. So Xing Qiu, Hu Tao, Raiden, and Diona and Mona. Those are the four people I need to level up. So in order to level up our friend Hu Tao, we have to go to fight the Jiobashaps. So if you guys have not seen the Jiobashaps, it's one of the mini boss battles on the map here. It is in the heart of Liyue. There he is right there. That is the Primo Jiobashap. He is the lesser cousin of Ajdaha. If you guys have fought Ajdaha before, which I might just fight Ajdaha. I might just show you guys the Ajdaha battle because I think I get stuff with Ajdaha on this one. So we'll do the Jiobashaps first, and then I'll fight Ajdaha because I don't think you guys have seen Ajdaha. Ajdaha is, as you guys know, if you guys know, in this game, each Archon, which is a god, they have a almost like a friend or somebody that essentially takes them to is their partner, I guess. And if you guys have been following, the first one was in Mondstadt. The first one is the Archon, Wind Archon, which I forget his name now. So anyway, I'll have to look it up. But the first one is there's four Archons. Obviously Zhongli is one in Liyue, and Zhongli's I guess his partner was essentially Ajdaha, and you guys will see Ajdaha. So each Archon has a partner. So in this particular case, let's see, it is Venti. Venti, he's the wind god, and of course he is in Mondstadt. Mondstadt's represented by the wind, so he's the wind god. Of course, his steward, I guess, I'm going to use steward, is Storm Terror, which is the giant dragon you have to fight. And I haven't fought that battle yet, too, and I'll follow that one. And of course, Zhongli is the god of earth. His partner is Ajdaha. He loves Osmanthus wine. I love this man. He is my favorite character by far. There's nobody even close. Then, of course, there's Raiden, came from Inazuma. Raiden's partner in crime is Yaimiko. So they are stewards, essentially. And then, of course, the last one was Nahida. Now, Nahida's partner in crime, from what I gathered, she is Lesser Lord Kuzunali, and Greater Lord Rukadavada was hers, basically a twin of hers. So she is just basically a younger version, I guess, of it. So according to the storyline, I still don't understand the storyline that well, but we'll have to share that later. So you guys can see all of the and most of these boss battles, as you guys can see, there is Primo Jovashap. And then Ajdaha is over here. Yeah, there's Ajdaha right there. Okay. So that is, we'll go to that one next and we'll fight that one since you guys have not seen Ajdaha yet on my channel. Ajdaha is a fun battle. It is a very difficult battle. And then, of course, Storm Terror is up here. That's his lair. Okay. And that's, of course, that's the dragon. And we can do that one later. I'll probably do that one on next episode. So while we're headed this way, let's go ahead and fight the Primo Jovashap first. And then we'll get into the other fun things. I'm going to change parties because this party doesn't do real well and I've got to upgrade them. So we'll go ahead to our base party here because Geo does not do good against Geo. The Primo Jovashaps, if you will. And it looks like today's sampling is ice. Or is that water? I can't tell. It looks like ice. Oh, it looks like water. All right, so we'll land him. He's a big boy. Ajdaha is this on crack. As you can see, she's hitting hard. Kokomi, I actually wrote down every artifact that I needed to get with them. Because, my God, I was getting the wrong artifacts. I was pumping the wrong stats. So thank you to Game8 and to Genshin Lab, those great websites for Genshin help. They have been absolutely fantastic to help me so I can figure out how in the world to stat my characters. Because, you know, it's if you're going in blind and you're trying to figure this out, it's just not fun. Water. It is water. We'll just shocking. But as you can see, I really have to do some work on their artifacts. That's all there is to it. But so far, they are hitting decent. They are doing okay. As you can see, I've gotten her Kokomi's hit points up about, what, 20%? Something along those lines. So there we go. So as you can see, they all hit really hard. The key to all of this, obviously, is the elemental bursts, but Kazuha gives them, if you notice Kazuha's stuff here, okay, Kazuha's burst, okay, his burst is important. It's a signature technique. It's an AoE animo damage, and then what it does is it does autumn whirlwind, and if it comes into contact with Hydro, Pyro, Cryro, or Electro, which everything except Dendro at the point, it will deal additional elemental damage. So he pumps stats, and then, of course, he also does the Chihayaburu, which basically brings everybody in. He's crowd control. So then, of course, Nahida's most important thing. This is why Nahida's skill is so important to Sino, because while Nahida remains within the shrine, the interval between each Tri-Karma purification that all schemes to know is decreased. So essentially, basically what is happening, the all schemes to know, karmic bonds, she fires out this little photograph and it puts everybody in, hooks everybody with Dendro damage. And then it basically does the seed, which triggers elemental reactions of different types. And there's Dendro damage on top of it. And then, of course, she enhances Sino's Quicken, which is an important Electro-Dendro combination. So there's a lot to it, guys. This is PhD stuff in Genshin today. So, all right. So here we go. We got the Bard's Feather. We got some Juvenile Jade. So you know what that means. That means it is time to level up our gal. Let's ascend her. I love Hu Tao.
I never imagined that I...
Hu Tao does not work unless it is with... She works very difficult unless it's with Zhongli. Zhongli's shield provides so much to her. And it's incredible what it does. So let's go down here to a battle. Looks like we got a claim on it. We can upgrade her. Right now, I am Mora poor. If you guys can see, I've got no Mora whatsoever. I've got 100,000 Mora, which in this game is dirt poor. So I got about as much money as Zhongli right now. All right, let's go and fight Ajdaha. You guys have not seen anything yet until we fight Ajdaha. So I need to do some pumping up. Ajdaha is very difficult. Okay, so let's go to level 80 first, and let me just show you the battle so I can actually win. Because, gosh, I don't even want to try to attempt level 90. Ajdaha is a primo Jovashap. As you guys can see, he's quite large. He's very, very big. So I want to make sure, I don't normally do this with bosses, but boy, we're going to pump up some delicious crit rate, and we're going to pump up some delicious defense. We need to get that done. So here we are. There's Ajdaha. Shall we engage? Let's rock and roll. We might go ahead and play your thing. There he is. He is a beast, an absolute beast. And this is a fun boss battle. Overstep your mortal authority. Oh, I'll overstep, buddy. Don't you worry about it. Just shaking the ground. He hits hard. Oh, lordy. All right. Let me get to my heels, please, sir. Thank you. Yeah, he's just a big softy. Yeah, it's time to die. Here he comes. He's absorbing water today. No, I don't witness anything. He's got a little tree on his back there for his tail. All right, come on, take him. Yeah, that's okay. Like I said, her heals outpace pretty much everything they can throw at us. She's healing at a 10% clip, I think, something along those lines. It's not that brash. Now they're doing Electro. Some of the most powerful beings in this game can wield multiple things. Now he's buried. Illusion shattered. Come on. He's burying himself. But as you can see, even on level 80, I can outpace it. Level 90, I don't think I can outpace the damage. But that's why I just wanted to show you the battle, because it is quite fun. And as you can see, Raiden's hitting harder as well. She's got her thing. All right, I got an achievement. What was that achievement? I don't even see what that was. See you later, buddy. Have a good day. Yeah, you're destroyed. Sorry. See you later, bud. I don't know what that means. All right, we'll just do that. Thank you. So he gives you the Dragon Lord's Crown. You get all that stuff. And, of course, you get lots of goodies, lots of good upgrades and stuff like that. And he drops electric and water, depending on what he's absorbed. So we'll leave the domain and see what the thing we got. I want to see the, what is it that we got? Let's take a look at the achievement. I didn't even see that. What is it? Ooh, Challenger Series 4. Ooh, defeat Ajda with ever having gained a shield. Well, that was level 80, so it was easy anyway. I dropped it down a little bit. All right, cool. So that was Ajdaha. So that is a fun little boss battle that you can get into. Now, you're only allowed to do this boss 3 times a week. So let's go over here to another boss I want to show you guys. Let's see here. Oh, yeah, she's down here. So there is somebody I need to upgrade my peeps, and that would be Signora, which Signora is very, very tough. It's a very tough boss. She is one of the 12 Harbingers. And so the Harbingers, in this case, if you guys, the Fatui Harbingers, if you guys have watched any of the if you guys know this game at all, the Fatui Harbingers are the bad guys. They are part of Shezhnaya, which is the Frost group. Now, what's great about this year is Fontaine is coming out. And if you guys notice, each of the Genshin worlds represent a real-life country. So in this particular case, Inazuma represents Japan, Liyue represents China, Mondstadt represents Germany, and then I think Sumeru represents Egypt, the Middle East, things like that. So it's a very good mix here. And then also the new one, Fontaine, which is going to be France, which is the Water Nation, which is going to be a lot of fun. That's coming out later this year. Looking forward to that as well. I'm loafing, buddy. Let's go ahead and do Senora on level 80 so I can show you guys. She's very difficult. Senora is one of the Fatui Harbingers, and they can wield dual elements. In this particular case,
you're trembling.
You kill her. Raiden kills her at the end of this in a cutscene. So she wields quite a bit. She wields ice and fire. So here's the ice level. And I'm frozen. Great. As you can see, it gets a little cold here, so we gotta sit back over here. And shush. Thank you. We'll go over here. We gotta get close, because this is the only thing that kind of sucks about the whole thing. Where are the butterflies? There are the butterflies. Ah, where's the butterflies? You see any butterflies? There's a butterfly. Thank you. There we go. Butterflies will help break this ice. Butterfly. Oh, I'm getting a little cold. Get it down. This is the hard part of this game, of this match, because you have to let it. Yes, thank you. I know, I'm trying to do this. All right. There we go. And like I said, her heals out-heal the damage I'm taking from, it's outlasting some of the damage. All right, take it easy. You're hitting me. Stop. All right, let's get warmed up a little bit. Look for more moths. There's another moth over there. I see it. Let me heat up real quick. Come on. Ah, nice and cold. All right, let's roll this way. Moth, give me a moth. Thank you. Wind strike. But you see how fast it hits. Shine down. All right, now's the next scene. She's basically turning into fire, Signora. This was a fun battle. I enjoyed doing this the first time. It was great. There she is, Crimson Witch of Embers. All right, here we go. This is where it gets a little dicey. As you can see, we're heating up. You can see even at level 80, it's a little difficult. Especially with the elemental factors and the environmental factors, you've got to stand next to the ice thing. You better watch out now. You better not. You better not. There is no escape. One with wind and claw. Allow me. Yeah. A battle. All right. Embrace your searing reckoning. But you do not want to destroy these things because they help you. Oh God, tornado time. Watch out. Here she comes. Hold you. Don't. Stay away from me, you psycho. Oh, Lord. Come on. Come on. Oh, Lordy. Ow, that hurt. No. All right. Cool down. Yeah, I dare.
A witch.
You are a witch. You're a terrible witch. Oh, Lord. Where did you go? There you are. Hello. And down goes Senora. There you go. So that is Senora's battle. So these are once a week things, and those give you these, which are very important, is Hellfire Butterfly. And let me show you why they're important. Because if you're going to Triple Crown your people, and when we talk about Triple Crown, we talk about attributes and talents. What we're going to do is talents. These right here, these are their main attributes. You notice they're their E skill, their Q skill, and their regular attack, okay? E is their regular, is their general power, and then Q is their burst power. As they get higher, they get these. And in order to get higher levels, they have to get very high-end items. So I want to triple crown her to get her skills up to the highest. That's where the grind in Genshin can get you. It's a little bit of a grind, but it's not terrible. So there was Senora. So after that, now let's, I'm not gonna, I don't think I want, do I want to do Storm Terror? Let's just do Storm Terror. What the heck? So this week, Genshin Week's gonna be fun because today we are just starting off by doing our general boss look at, and then I'm going to start doing some questing this week because I definitely need to do some questing. I'm way behind on questing, and I'm going to do some character quests, which will be really nice. I can't wait to do some of those quests. And there's some character quests I haven't done, like Sino. I haven't done, I've done Tanari, but I haven't done Sino. Now, here is Storm Terror. Storm Terror is fun. He's a big boy. Come on down here, buddy. Let's have a seat. Let's have a chat. Yeah. All right, watch out. I gotta get his shield down first. There is no escape. Come on down here, buddy. There you go. Hello, let me get your paw here. All right, he's down. Let's go. Get up there. Climb. Go. Come on. Oh my god, really?
Commit. One with nature.
That's what I need to do.
Illusion shattered.
All right, that's how we do it. I gotta climb up, though. Healy timey. Do not. All right, the first part of this battle, when you first did it, it was shooting him on a, oh, it's raining, okay. All right, I need to run this way. I need to run away, I need to, okay. There should be no, okay, I'm taking damage. It doesn't really matter at this point. Let's light it up. All right, so, come on, put yourself down here, buddy. There you go. Thank you.
Shine down.
Down he goes. Let's go up.
Illusion shattered.
Right on your head, buddy. And as you can see, Kakomi hits hard. Hard. Level 80. There he goes. See you later, bud. Have a good day. All right, so we've done our weeklies. Fantastic. So there's the Valen. So that is it. We are done with our bosses for the week. And that will be it for our first episode of Genshin Week. Welcome, guys. Welcome back to Lodestar Gaming. Sorry I've been gone so long. We are going to do our weekly missions and claim our stuff. Nice. So if you guys need anything, just please give me a subscription. Give me a subscribe. I hope you enjoy my content. I'm going to have all week this week. We're going to have every day this week at 3 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time, releasing a new episode of me playing this freaking awesome game. I'll see you guys later. Take care.
Yeah, I publish it.